Well, it looks like Valen has gone Bruce Jenner on us and has used those two things at his side to create two things, the barrier and also this creature right here. Now, you will want to be taking this creature down, but know that it will come back very shortly. Your main goal is actually Valen. You need to break that shield that he has around his body. But the thing is, the reason you want to take this guy out is because he has an ability that actually heals that shield. We do not want that. You want to take this guy out while avoiding attacks like this. There we go. Get hits on her when him, her, whatever you can. Jeez, I guess Valen's into crossplay, isn't he? Yeah, I had a much harder time with this fight last time, but it's no biggie now, but Valen does like to sort of float away from you in an awkward way, and it's hard to really get a sense of depth perception, but you always want to head toward this weird puppety creature here. Oh, he's caught me in a loop. There we go. Because he walks just as fast as you do, so trying to catch up with him is not a good idea. You want to walk the other way. Oh, crap. No. This is his healing move. If he stands up straight like that, he's trying to heal him with the shield. And this sends shockwaves, so jump whenever he lands. Oh, no. Don't do the thing. Okay. Oh, you almost got me there. Got you. I usually only get one hit, but it'd be hard to hit sometimes. Okay. One more and it should do it. I might be able to just ignore this guy. There we go. That was easy. And now we get to the true final boss of this game. It is Valen, who has become one with the Dewprism. Now, this fight is interesting, as you can see, since Ru has his hat off, Ru can use the guard technique. And he will use different forms, and there's only one form that you can actually hurt him in. And it's not this one. Okay, yeah, just run straight direction. Come on, he's not getting in that form. Oh, there we go. So you can press triangle and you can block, so that's what it is. So you can't transform into any enemy, but once he hits you, starts hitting you with that, put your guard up, and once he finishes, then you can hurt him. You can't hurt him into any of these other forms, as far as I'm aware. So yeah, just run, avoid, all that good stuff. I don't know why he doesn't figure, hey, there's only one way he can hurt me, so maybe I should avoid this form, but no. So it's an interesting final boss. I don't think we've seen this one quite yet, but yeah, just going around in circles. I wish, yeah, Ru would walk when I walk in that direction. When I go in that direction. Oh well. I guess that's what I get for trying to play this with the PlayStation 4 controller. But it's all good. Alright, come on, buddy, bring it on. Dude, okay, you're not doing anything in this form, just go ahead and change. You didn't change anything, you're back in the same form. Come on, dude. I got a lot luckier with him the last time because he pretty much was changing into the vulnerable form all the time, but he's being a bit more stubborn this time. There we go. Just hold down block, let him get some hits on you, and get a hit on him. One more, and he is down. Ow. That's okay, he's continually dropping health blasts and magic blasts, though I don't know what, you can't even use magic in this fight, so why does he do that? I don't know. Alright, one more block. Oh, you can use magic. Oh, jeez, look at him. I never noticed this before, because it wouldn't let you open this menu, but look at Ru when he has his hat off here. That is a nice touch. That is the first time I've ever noticed that. I guess you can turn into a creature, but I don't know why you'd want to. But one more hit. and once more we are in control of Rue. We have fought the final fight, but we are not quite done yet, and we can do one more save. I'll see you soon.